What is up, YouTube? Welcome back to the Los Angeles Dodgers franchise, and today your Los Angeles Dodgers will be playing in the May 30th game at O'Dako Coliseum in Oakland against the Oakland Athletics. You'll see Los Angeles Dodgers 29-23, having a good run here in May, and the A's are 23-27, trying to get back on track to get the 500 to hopefully compete here once we get to the playoff race. But here you see they're a Sonny Gray, 3-4, 3.97 ERA, not having a good year. But there's Corey Seager, 317, 8 home runs and 28 RBIs. You see in lineup there's Puig, Crawford, Seager, Gonzalez, Turner, Van Slyke, Hernandez, Grandal, and Kendrick. Decided to put Van Slyke in the DH today because he's been hitting well. Hopefully that'll prove to be a good thing. 1-2 count here to Seager, though. He's gonna fly this one in the right field, and this will be a very quick top of the first. 1-2-3 inning for Sonny Gray, who's trying to come back. But here's Julio Urias, 1-3, 6.50 ERA. Had a couple of decent games where he only let up like 3 or 4 earned runs, but didn't get the run support. But he's had a couple of games where he just did not pitch well. So hopefully he pitches well today. The full count here, Seager is not going to help the cause. He's going to bobble that one. No play at first base, and they have a runner on. 1-2 count, though, two down here. Later in the inning, fly ball to right field, and Urias comes back well after that error. And he gets a quick inning there. So we head to the top of the second inning. 1-2 count here to Gonzalez. He gets a high fastball. I chase. That was a bad swing, bad pitch, and I went for it. 1-1 here now to Van Slyke. He's going to hit this one hard to left field. I've loved hitting with Van Slyke so far, but that is right to the left fielder. And that is going to be out number 3 in another quick top of the second inning. So you see the NL West standings right here. 29-23, leading the division against the San Francisco Giants, one game back, and the Colorado Rockies 2.5 games back. So it's still a big time race here at the beginning of the year. Almost every team in the division is contending, so we really need to keep on the pace. But right here is not helping, as it is a double for the Oakland A's. Shane Victorino with that double. Two outs, though. Line drive right to Seager. He makes the play, and we get out of the inning. So through two, not a whole lot, just a couple of hits. We don't even have a hit yet. Full count, one down. Could we finally get our first hit? Grandal does give us our first hit here in the top of the third inning, but we need to get something going here. One down in the inning. Can we get a rally going? Here's Kendrick with a full count once again. Really working the count, but this time tries to hold up his swing, but he went, and that is strike three. So two down now in the inning. Full count. The runner's on the move. Ball 40 yards. Yasiel Puig, we're getting something going here. It'll be Carl Crawford up next. First and second. 1-2 count, two down. He's going to hit this one in the left center. That one is going to be in the gap. They're going to get a run in. Grandal's rounding. Puig's going to be rounding third. Crawford's heading for third. They're going to throw to Crawford. They're just going to let up the run and get Crawford out of third base. But nonetheless, it's a 2-RBI double for Carl Crawford. Gets us some big runs there in the top of the third inning. Probably could have held him at third, but figured they'd throw it home like they usually do, but they did not. Now the A's are trying to respond here. Here's Billy Butler, I do believe, hits this one to the right center gap. Kike Hernandez is going to run it down at the wall, and that is going to be a double for the A's, trying to get those two runs back. Full count, one down. Here's a pitch lined in the center field. Kike Hernandez is going to have to come up throwing. The runner is not moving. The 32 speed is not enough, but they have runners on the corner. One down. Can Urias get his way out of this inning somehow? Full count once again. That's going to be a line drive in the right field. That is going to be an RBI single. And the A's get one back here in the bottom of the third inning. Still not the inning now. 3-1 pitch. Hit in the center field. The runner at second base is going to tag. Kike Hernandez has been busy this inning. He's going to come up throwing, and actually, surprisingly, they're not going to tag up the runner. So it's going to be first and second. 1-2 down. That's a pitch in the dirt, and that's going to advance the runner, so no need to tag on that last one. Still two strikes on the man, though. Can Urias come back? 2-2 pitch. That is a nice pitch by Julio Urias. Strikes him out, and he gets out of that one with only one run allowed. Here's a full count, one down, top of the fourth. Adrian Gonzalez, that's a ball. 4 with one down, get a runner on base. Adrian Gonzalez, though, only about 7 speed. 2-1 pitch, though, to Scott Van Slyke. He's going to hit that one to center field. This one, he got most of it on the barrel, and it's gone. Scott Van Slyke. My goodness, you remember from the St. Louis Cardinals episode, he hit one out in the left field. This time, just a line drive shot into center field. Scott Van Slyke. two-run shot. That walk seems to be pretty big now. Instead of a solo shot, it's a two-run homer. His fourth of the year, 408 feet. You'll get to look at the swing again. I didn't think he knew it was out. I thought he just knew he hit it hard. And look, you'll see right here, he knew he hit it hard, and he just decided to take off with it. And it ended up just being so hard of a hit of a ball. It hits off that wall out there in center field. It's a two-run homer. Here's Kike Hernandez up next. He's going to hit that one into right center field on the slider. He's going to be rounding first base. He's going to head in the second. The inning is not over yet in the top of the fourth. Kike Hernandez keeps it alive. It's going to be for Grandal. We got a single in his first at bat. 1-2 pitch. The 12-6. That is gone. Wow, Yasmani Grandal, the 12-6 curveball left over the heart of the plate, and he got all of it to left center field. That is gone. Wow, two-run homers in the inning, and we take a commanding 6-1 lead here in the top of the fourth inning. Grandal, seventh. I usually don't even hit well. I think that's the first time I've ever hit a home run. I play even these franchise games when I'm not recording. I just play them just for fun because I enjoy the series, and I don't think I've ever hit a home run on Grandal, and he gets it that time. He got all of that one, and Howie Kendrick gets all of this one. This one's in the deep center field, but it's tracked down. Wow, that would have been impressive. Three home runs in one inning. But instead, we get two in one inning. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Urias comes out with some run support. He strikes Billy Butler out there. Now, can Urias get a clean inning? Full count, one down to the next batter, Shane Victorino. That's ball four. Just a tad low. Not a bad pitch. 1-2 pitch now to the next guy. That's going to hit him in the foot. That's supposed to be a slider that ends up in the zone. Instead, it hits Lowry, and now we are in some trouble again. But instead, Urias gets a ground ball. Kendrick to Seager to Gonzalez. Big double play to get out of the inning, and we head to the bottom of the fifth. We get nothing going at the top of the fifth. Full count pitch. Billy Burns just gets blown away by a fastball by Urias. Having a good day so far. That's a nice pitch from Urias. Full count, two down to Valencia. He's going to take ball four. Not a good pitch on that one. The slider, he lost control. 1-1 pitch to the next batter. Flight in the center field. That one is towards the gap. Can Kike Hernandez get under it? And he can. Gets out of the inning unscathed once again. We're going to head to the top of the sixth. It's Vance Leick. They want no part of him. Sonny Gray's out of the game now. And they knew what Vance Leick did earlier in the game. 2-1 pitch to Kike Hernandez. That's going to be a line drive into right field. That gets down out there. And that is going to be a single for Hernandez. He has a double and a single on the day. Top of the sixth, Grandal once again, full count. Ball four. They didn't want any part of Grandal either. Bases loaded, one down. Can we get something going here? Howie Kendrick, full count. Pops that one up to left field. Vance Leick is not the fastest there on third base. No way we're going to be able to send him. So now it's two down, bases loaded. Yasiel Puig, he's going to hit this one up the middle, but a nice play at short. Flipped on to second. That was a big play. Saves two runs, and we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. 2-1 pitch, Urias. That's going to be down the third baseline, turning, can't quite get it. Crawford's going to have to come field it. They start out the inning very strong. We're going to need Urias to get out of this inning. I can get him through six, I hope. 1-1 pitch. Urias, that's off his foot. Seager's going to try to make a play. He takes his time, a bad throw, and Butler beats that one. I don't know why Seager threw that so slow, but Urias, thankfully, he would be okay. You see him limping around out there a little bit, but he'd be fine. Took that one off the leg. He'd be all right to go. Full count, nobody down. Here's a grounder up the middle. It's knocked down by Seager, and then no one covers either base anywhere. So it's going to be bases loaded, nobody out. Can Urias find his way out of here? No, because we're going to take him out right there. Bases loaded, nobody out. Urias, not a bad day. 5-plus innings. Only one earned so far, but he could be responsible. He is responsible for the three on the base, and we're going to bring in Chris Hatcher. Has had a fantastic year so far, and I need him to get out of this jam. Full count, nobody down. That's going to be a line drive into left field. That's a nice catch by Carl Crawford, but he throws it to the cutoff man. It'll be nowhere near in time to get the runner. Sacrifice fly. Now, can he just keep it painless? 2-2 pitch popped up behind second base. Kendrick's going to catch this one, and that is a big out number two. Can he save these runs? Runners on the corners. 2-2 pitch. Hatcher popped up in the left field. Chris Hatcher comes in and does a fantastic job. Urias has to be happy with that. Only two earned runs on the day. Could have been up to four. Bases low, nobody out. Instead, Chris Hatcher comes in, only lets up the one run, and that was on a sacrifice fly. What a job right there by Chris Hatcher out of the pen. 2-2 pitch here, top of the seventh. That's going to be a ground ball in the right field. That's going to get through out there. The 8-speed Adrian Gonzalez gets a single. If he would have fielded that even that deep, he would have been out for sure. But 3-1 pitch now, Justin Turner's going to walk. So we got something going here in the seventh inning. Full count, two down for Scott Van Slyke. Dribbles that one to third base. Throw on the first. He is out of there. And we head to the bottom of the seventh inning. 2-2 pitch. Chris Hatcher still in there. And he strikes out Simeon right there. Nice pitch by Chris Hatcher. He's doing a good job out of the pen. 1-2 pitch at the line in the left field by Valencia. Not going to get him out on a fastball inside. Got to do better with him. But 1-1 pitch to the next batter. That's going to be flied in the right field. And Chris Hatcher pitched a beautiful two innings right there. He let up one hit. He didn't let up any runs. He's still in the bottom of the eighth. 1-1 pitch. Ground ball to first base. And what a job Chris Hatcher has done out of the pen. Three innings. Three strong innings. He had retired nine batters, but only left one on base. And that was quite the job. We had some insurance. Here's Yasiel Puig off the wall. Almost got out of there. But instead, Yasiel Puig's going to have a double here. Finally gets on base on the day. I still can't believe Chris Hatcher pitched that good. In real life, you know he's not very good. And he's really bad out of the pen as you see Corey Seager strike out there. But in here, he did a great job. Three strong innings. I'll take that anytime. Adrian Gonzalez strikes out, and we leave Puig stranded at second base. We head to the bottom of the ninth, though. Can we shut the door? Pedro Baez, 1-1 pitch that hits off Pedro Baez, and thankfully it did. Kendrick can make the play then. Usually you don't want your pitchers to get hit, but that time I was happy. Billy Burns, he's just blown away by a 97-mile-an-hour fastball. Good job right there by Pedro Baez to get the out. Full count, two down. Simeon, line drive to center field. Didn't he bring in Kenley Jansen for the save because it's not a save opportunity, so I kept him in pen, gave him some rest, and here Pedro Baez gets a fly out to deep center field, and your Los Angeles Dodgers get a 6-2 victory. Julio Urias with a great day today, 5-plus innings, 2 earned runs, 3 Ks I believe, but more importantly, gets a win and gets some confidence back, and that was just a great game. We hit the ball well early in the third inning, especially with those two-run homers, and that led us all the way. Grandal, your top hitter, 2-for-3, 2 runs, 1 home run, 2 RBIs. Pretty good day. We got Sonny Gray out there early, 6-2 win. I'm very happy with that, and that was a much-needed victory to keep our pace at the top of the division. We've really been keeping our pace up pretty well in the month of May, but hopefully we can continue that into June because we're going to need some big wins in June against the Giants and the Colorado Rockies. But I hope you guys did enjoy, and as always, I'm out. Peace.